Here we have an oxidation-reduction reaction. It takes place in acidic solution, and it's suggested that we use the half reaction method to write down the complete equation. We only have three species here, so what this means is that this ion containing iodine is going to go to I3-, but also, I- is going to I3-. So here you can see the real advantage of using this half reaction method. We have two half reactions, and then we want to follow a systematic procedure. The first is what we've already done, the half reactions. The second is to balance the oxygen by adding water. This means on the right side, we would need to add three waters to balance that equation. And then we have to balance hydrogens by adding H+. So on this side, we need to add six hydrogens. And now that's balanced. We need to balance the iodine. So I was a little too quick to do this. We first should have balanced the iodine, so we can see we have three iodine on each side. It's actually nine oxygen atoms to balance both sides, and this says there is now 18 hydrogen ions. Likewise, in the second reaction, I'll balance the iodine. Our third step in this procedure is to balance the charge. So balancing the charge means adding electrons. In the second reaction, I have minus one charge on the right side. I have minus three on the left side. So we need to add two electrons. The first reaction, minus one on the right side, plus 18 here, minus three, plus 15. So this would say 16 electrons. So we've balanced charge on both sides. Our next step is to recombine these two equations. So to combine the half reactions, and we combine them so that charges, electrons balance, which means we would take this equation times one, and this equation times 8, so that we have 16 electrons on both sides and electrons drop out. So I combined the two equations, multiplying the second by 8. Now the electrons cancel. Careful here, I forgot to add the 9 waters here. Now I have a complete equation. And the last step is to verify that this is correct. So I do that, I have 18 hydrogen atoms on the left side, I have 18 on the right, I have 9 oxygen atoms on the left, 9 on the right, I have 27 iodine on the left, and I have 27 iodine on the right. And the last thing is the charge balance, so 18 plus 18 minus 3 minus 24 on the left, and on the right minus 1 minus 8. So this is minus 9, also minus 9. So we have the correct balanced equation, and you can see it's unlikely we would have been able to balance this equation by inspection. Following the systematic procedure, directly get the balanced equation for this oxidation-reduction reaction. I was a little too quick to write down that answer because I forgot to check. I can divide this entire equation by 3, so I have 6 hydrogen ions plus IO3- plus 8 iodines, 3I3- and 3 water. So this, we always want to have the smallest possible integers. balanced equation. So this is the correct balanced equation.